The Real Life Story of Edith Pretty, of Sutton Hoo. The story of the great ship burial of Sutton Hoo is an integral part of England's national heritage. And without the vision of landowner and patron of the sciences, Edith Pretty, the monumental discovery of a ship containing the treasure of a king, who was probably the last of the pagan rulers of East Anglia, would have remained hidden beneath the earth. A recent Netflix movie released in January 2021, called The Dig, based upon a novel of the same name, tells the story of the excavation and the woman who spurred the discovery by using her own funds to commission amateur archaeologist Basil Brown from Ipswich Museum to start digging on her land looking for the graves of ancient warriors. Edith Pretty's real-life story is, in itself, a dramatic tale of a woman who was ahead of her time in the many facets of her life, including exposure to scientific methods and archaeological digs from an early age, to her interest in the male-defined field of archaeology, along with a dash of spiritualism acquired later in life. In this video, I cover the life history of Edith Pretty and how her thirst for knowledge and her spirit of adventure led to a triumphant life resulting in one of the most magnificent archaeological finds in England. Stay to the end to find out what is true in the Netflix movie and what is not true. We'll use the timestamps in the description to get there faster. So, who was the real Edith Pretty? First, let me say that a lot of information about Edith Pretty and photos of the real Edith Pretty and her family can be found at this blog by a descendant of her family. I left a link below in the description so you can see actual photos of the real Edith Pretty. Edith May Pretty was born of Scottish descent on August 1, 1883, in Elland, Yorkshire, England. Her family had reaped the rewards of the Industrial Revolution and were able to bring her and her sister up in wealth and higher education. Edith's upbringing fit the norm of well-to-do women in Edwardian society of the early 1900s England. She was well-educated, articulate, public-spirited, and provided the advantages to develop an interest in science and archaeology from an early age. Edith was first exposed to the world of science by her wealthy grandfather, who dabbled in the study of astronomy, and later by her father. Her father was a strong believer in the educational importance of international travel. Each year, as a girl, she and her sister Elizabeth went to the continent with their parents, visiting Pompeii, the Egyptian pyramids and tombs, and the monuments at Luxor. In Egypt, she saw some of the excavations take place in the Nile Valley, done by a family friend who was an Egyptologist on the dig. An understanding of excavation methods was built upon when her father undertook his own excavation of a Cistercian abbey church that adjoined their house at Vale Royal. As she grew into a woman at the turn of the century, Edith did a great deal of public and charity work. She became quartermaster of the local Red Cross military hospital shortly after the start of World War I in 1914 and ran a house as a shelter for a number of Belgian refugees. And, in 1917, she served with the French Red Cross. However, her life was by no means completely dedicated to civic service. Edith was athletic and a keen horsewoman, and as a young woman, she would go hunting and fishing with her family at their country home. Always eager to do something different. In her 40s, Edith went on a pony trek across Iceland. Long days in the saddle on rugged terrain while living under highly primitive circumstances was never a hardship for Edith. While Edith lived during the time that women were brought up as socialites and taught to seek out marriage at an early age, Edith chose not to marry until she was 42. In 1926, a year after her father died, she married Colonel Frank Pretty, who had first proposed to her when she was 18. With the money from her father's inheritance, Mrs. Pretty purchased the house and 400-acre estate known as Sutton Hoo. It was a windy heathland that included 18 low-earth mounds considered to be burial mounds. And this is where the movie, The Dig, takes off. In the movie, Frank Pretty has died and it is 4 years later. After wondering, all those years prior, what treasures might be found in the mounds, Edith took action and hired amateur archaeologist Basil Brown to begin an investigation into its possible contents. Setting aside the fact that there was no real romance, as suggested in the movie between Mrs. Pretty and Basil Brown, although they did become good friends, Edith, with her prior knowledge of archaeology, clear that she wanted the work to proceed in proper scientific fashion. The movie might portray that Edith wanted to be known for the unearthing of the 88-foot burial ship from the 7th century and the other valuable artifacts from a Saxon royal burial. History tells us that this was not exactly true to her nature. When Edith donated the treasure to the British Museum, Prime Minister Winston Churchill wanted to make her a commander of the Order of the British Empire for her contribution to archaeology, but she declined. Edith Pretty was a private person, and as shown in the movie, she did not welcome the attention that the excavation got after Ipswich Museum curator Guy Maynard gave the story to the press, resulting in a horde of journalists and planes flying over to get photos. It said that, on several occasions, she threatened to shut down the Dig entirely. A good part of the drama in the Dig movie centers around the immense importance of the burial ship and the treasure trove found in the mounds. It is true that there were many people wanting to claim credit for the discovery and take control of the excavations. And it is true that there was an inquest that determined Edith was, without question, the owner of the treasure trove, and it was hers to do with as she wished. Not only did Edith donate the treasure trove to the British Museum, so that the meaning and excitement of her discovery could be shared by everyone, she also paid, out of pocket, for the expense of Basil Brown's work on the dig, as well as paying for security to guard the excavation site from looters once the discovery had been exposed to the public. As for her foray into spiritualism, Edith Pretty did befriend a faith healer named William Parrish when her husband fell ill before his death. It is said that Edith funded the construction of a chapel for Parrish, and that she supported the Woodbridge Spiritualist Church. According to the History vs. Hollywood website, it was only a rumor that either Edith or a friend of hers had dreams and visions of soldiers walking around with swords and spears atop the mounds on her property. One more thing to clarify is that Mrs. Pretty was 55 years old when excavations began at Sutton Hoo, while, in the movie, she appears to be much younger. She was most certainly ill at the time of the dig, and had only a few more years to live. Edith Pretty died from a stroke, December 17, 1942, at the age of 59. There is no doubt that Edith Pretty was an extraordinary woman, who was ahead of her time, and that England and the world will be forever grateful for her contributions to the science of archaeology. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe for more videos on the fabulous, fierce, and feisty women in history.